Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. Two wide receivers will be looking to be number one targets on the field in today's game. It's Macklin's Chiefs going up against Beckham's Giants. With that, let's get up to MetLife Stadium as we welcome in our guys, Brandon Guyden and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Kansas City Chiefs and the New York Giants. Set to go now on a beautiful sunny afternoon. And we are underway from MetLife Stadium. Tyreek Hill on the return. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. Carry, it's Davis. And not much. Maybe a yard up to the 29. This is the offense we're going to see coming up in this one, and Travis Kelce will be key.
What a tremendous weapon he is, especially in the red zone. Knows how to find the end zone when running his routes.
8 yards to go here on second down. A shotgun snap for Smith. And his throw is incomplete. Travis Kelce, the Pro Bowl tight end, the intended target. Charles, for the Giants defense here, looking forward to next season, what do they need to improve and where are they solid?
I think that they'll want to continue to get better at the linebacker position. I think they want to add another pass rusher because Olivier Vernon, who was a free agent pickup in 2016, did a tremendous job coming off the edge. I thought they really shored up their interior with Damon Harrison, a defensive tackle. Landon Collins played at an MVP level on the defensive side of the ball as safety, and Janoris Jenkins became an eraser out on the corner.
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
That'll be put in the books as a... 53-yard punt. And the Giants' drive will start from deep in their territory with a first and 10. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. A first carry now for Paul Perkins. And that closed up quickly there as he gets it up only to about the 17. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. Again, they go to Perkins. And a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. Only a gain of a couple there. That leaves him needing about 7 here on third down. And let's take a look at the defensive starters for Kansas City.
Eric Berry's a textbook definition of ball-hawking safety. You name it, he can do it on the football field.
Manning on third down, and he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
So it looks like the offense isn't going anywhere. They're going to go for it on 4th and 7. Here we go on 4th down with Manning. And this is incomplete. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And now possession's going to go over with a football at the 20-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went 3 and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion, guys a little bit jumpy.
Oh, you do.
Oh, you understand the same way. Just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went 3 and out.
And now to have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go 3 and out. I went 3 and out on that first drive. I'll try to do better here. So now 11 yards to go for this offensive unit. It's second down. Now a play fake, and it's Smith. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
Defense has set themselves up nicely. 3rd and 10 now. It's a 4-receiver look to the right side. Here's Smith, flushed out right. And that is caught by Macklin for the Kansas City touchdown. Jeremy Macklin from 19 yards away. And the Chiefs are going to take a first quarter lead. And he's got it up and through. Now, after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. And New York set to take the field. And last time out, went for it on 4th down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned it to 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do and the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on 4th down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
The drive starts with a run by Perkins. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Brandon, it's early in this one, but Paul Perkins is a guy that I saw play at UCLA. And you know when he did his most damage? Late in the ball game. He's one of those guys that's a high-volume ball carrier and really wears people down and produces big as the game's on the line.
Had some good moments for the Giants this year. Question, though, is he just a complimentary piece going forward, or can he ever be the guy?
I think he can be the guy, but I don't believe the Giants are just going to settle for that. They're going to bring in more competition and make him earn it.
possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Able to carve out about six there, down to the 37.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, and it's the Giants with a football here as we begin quarter number two. They've got it second and four to start things out. Second down. And complete to Lewis over the middle. And he doesn't quite make it. They do stop him, but he gets it all the way down to the one.
Now that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
It's a sneak, Manning, and he takes it into the end zone for a Giant TD. Eli Manning scoring on the sneak from a yard out, and the Giants are an extra point away from tying up this football game. It's good, and we're all tied at seven apiece. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. To throw on second down is Smith. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Macklin. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. So here we go, first and 10 now. Now Davis. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a second and one.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
On second down, here's Smith. And this one's incomplete. For the offense after the incomplete pass. They'll let the fullback try and pick it up. This is Anthony Sherman. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
On third and one, it seems natural to just turn and hand it to the biggest guy you have in the backfield. But usually, he's not the primary runner. So for the defense, they're often keying on the running back because he's the guy who gets the ball more often, and the fullback is the blocker. When he ends up carrying the football, that's a heck of a tendency breaker. And now you're just trying to jump on his back to hold on.
Davis, and he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. They'll come up now in the Wildcat package.
Here we go.
And some space here. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
And that run was what a lot of people call an explosive run. Gave them good yardage, solid yardage. They feel good about the whole thing, and they did it behind a two tight end set. It's always interesting to watch what offenses want to do with the two tight ends. Sometimes they line them up together for a power set. Sometimes they put one on each side of the line of scrimmage to balance things out. No matter what, though, when you see two tight ends on the field, your first thought is to think of run. In this case, the offense was able to run successfully.
And the offense there, the O-line, everybody really on offense, they were just manhandled at the point of attack.
Yeah, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? Almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. But how about that defensive front creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a lost yardage possibility?
Eluding the pressure right. To the right side, and he's got Macklin. Complete. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 to the 5-yard line. Now the Giants will stop play as they take a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Kelce out in the slot right. First and goal from the 5. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to take it into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Nile Davis, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Chiefs have taken the lead.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now, see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second quarter. That's fielded in the end zone. And with a new rule, that decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he only gets to the 20. And here comes the Giants offense back out onto the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
A little lull in the action here to go over an offseason storyline. It's kind of interesting. L.A. a couple years ago, they have no teams, and now they're going to have two with the move from San Diego to L.A. What does that mean for the league and for the Chargers?
It seems like an easier transition, doesn't it, than St. Louis when they moved back to Los Angeles.
Less culture shock.
Less culture shock, less, you know, obviously geography, the whole deal. But it's a transition is not going to be easy. Remember, they're going to go play in a soccer stadium, essentially, for at least the first couple of years before they share a stadium with the Rams. So that changes things. Obviously, trying to create an identity in the market they haven't been in a long time. They began as the Los Angeles Chargers, but only played one season as such.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. From the gun on third down, Manning. He finds Beckham complete. And he's going to be out of bounds at the 39.
Well, that's the kickstarter right there. Eli Manning finding his guy, Odell Beckham Jr.
Yeah, it's a deadly combination, isn't it?
It really is, but what really makes it work is just how unflappable Eli is with his demeanor, able to maintain his calm and his poise, because we know OBJ, he can run pretty hot and get excited out there.
Sometimes just one-handed grabs for him.
It doesn't matter what it is. Just throw it up there. He'll go get it.
On first and 10, here's Manning. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people, bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
Manning again here on second and 10, surveying the field. It's hauled in by Shepard. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And the hard count got the defense there. Encroachment and the 5-yard penalty. So a first down and 5 for the offense. Again, it's Manning. This is caught inside the 15. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So with 1 second left in the half on it. Now here's a defensive timeout called by the Chiefs. So as they take it over, we step aside. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. The Giants offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. Tom Mahaly coming in from that outside linebacker spot. He gets him down for a loss of 5. On second down, here's Manning. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. He was looking for Odell Beckham that time. And it's third down.
Whenever they're trying to attack a zone defense, you're trying to figure out where your gaps are going to be. And depending on what type of zone they're playing, it could be on the outside, it could be in the middle, it could be in the seams, in the edges. In this case, they tried to attack the middle of the field, but this zone defense didn't allow it because they were able to see the ball come off the quarterback's hands and everyone was able to react to the football and knock it away.
On third and long, it's Manning. Caught right side, it's Lewis. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver up.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. D Ford in there to sack him for a loss of six. The Chiefs offense now making their way back onto the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. Here's Davis now. And some room to work. Powers over it.
Just fed him his pads, didn't he?
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Give him 16 on the pickup, and it'll give the Chiefs a first down. In the red zone this time. They go again with Davis. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Kelce out in the slot right. Play clock winding down. Here's Smith. And this is caught. Jeremy Maclin. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
Only a yard that time, second and goal.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown,
you're
without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
They'll need to get the playoff quickly. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is the time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being four down territory.
That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
On offense, the guy that you want to have the best eyes on the field are your quarterback, so you can see everything pre-snap, and then, of course, as the play develops. On defense, oftentimes it's the linebacker, and on this play, his eyes took him right to the ball, and he made a nice tackle.
Five wides in the game, four of them to the right side. Here we go on fourth, Smith. And it is incomplete. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And this Giants defense able to come up with a goal line stand. The Giants offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on four, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold up.
But he trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Welcome back now here in East Rutherford. It's a gain of four there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
Manning now on first down. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. Just a 1 yard pickup on the play, and it'll make it a second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Throwing on second down toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. The Pro Bowler Odell Beckham, the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down. Manning on third down and incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Oh man, for him to be that wide open and drop it, sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. One score down, here we go. They're gonna go for it here on fourth down. Now Manning, gotta have this one. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Justin Houston, in there to get him for a loss of five. So now here are the Chiefs as their offense makes their way back out onto the field. And last time, they had it fourth and goal, rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together another drive.
Hey, a simple tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one play that didn't allow them to get into the end zone.
And this time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do. And they'll start this drive with very good field position. They come up in an offset eye. Now they try the right side here. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Well, now they'll try the end around. They get 9 out of the... And now the Giants will stop play as they take a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They come out here in the eye. They'll try and get it in with Sherman, the fullback. And he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. Anthony Sherman taking it in. And the Chiefs add on to their lead. It's good, and it's 21-10. Now, after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. And New York set to take the field. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. Now Manning, and he finds a man on the crossing route. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. A good start there on first down. They've got to have this drive.
No doubt about it. Down a couple of scores. They have to find a way to put it in the end zone. Chunk plays, explosive plays, that will be the key to this drive. We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Back to the air on second down. It's Manning. Left side, it's Beckham, and he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. Give him 30 yards there.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield, but when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by the free safety, Eric Berry. And out come the Chiefs now. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. It's a loss of a yard. And now the Giants, they get the officials' attention and take another timeout. That's going to be their second. They'll be left with one more plus the two-minute warning. And we'll be back. A little bit of ground to make up for the offense as they face a second and 11. And on the ground they go with a running back. And he's going to be taken down here at about the 10. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That will be their third and final stoppage as they'll only have the two-minute warning now remaining. And if they want to keep this drive alive, they'll need 8 yards here on third down. Kelce out in the slot right. So a defensive brain lapse there and an encroachment penalty.
Sometimes when you don't watch the football and make sure that it's snapped, you're watching the offensive player, and they can influence you occasionally and look like they're getting ready to move, and the officials don't detect it.
And five in the secondary now for the Giants on third down. Out of the gun, Smith. And he's going to be brought down. Back at his own 6-yard line. B.J. Goodson coming in to drop him for a loss of 8. And it'll be fourth down. Time for a break. We'll come back and see this one out after this. Here's Dustin Colquitt now, on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Seven-yard punt, a return of 4. And it'll be Giant football first and 10. The New York set to take the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going.
Under pressure here, and down he goes. sacked back at about the 43-yard line. Well, you don't usually get a sack from a nose tackle spot, but we got one there.
No, we don't. And a lot of the times in passing situations, they end up off the field anyway. So how happy was he to work his way back to the quarterback and put him on the ground? He's going to end up with a nickname after something like that, some big jelly or something like that.
And they're out of timeouts, remember, so this is going to have to be a delay. But not the position they want to be in. Still a very, very small chance here, but they almost need a miracle.
Agreed. That means they've got to get it to the sidelines, get out of bounds, and preserve clock.
Second down, here's Manning. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Will tie the intended receiver. Third down here.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
In motion left, Shepherd. Now Manning. And that's complete to Lewis. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Here's Manning to throw. So he makes the grab, and this is intercepted, and that should do it. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to come from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general.
And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked off by Dominique Rodgers-Cromartie. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. And New York set to take the field. They have a little bit of time left here, but this one not going to go their way.
And this is where, in this situation for me, you just go ahead and run out the clock.
And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. Now the Chiefs offensive unit ready to do battle again. The clock cannot be stopped here. Defense can't do anything. So kneel it down, take it home.
No doubt about it. It's what you practice for in winning situations each and every week. Victory formation. Take a knee and go on into the locker room and celebrate.
Call it a victory. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Defense in a good spot. Let's see how the offense responds with a second and 13 now.
And Brandon, it's really no surprise to see them running the ball here. They've got the lead. There's not much time left. They just want to keep the clock moving and seal the win.
And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you primed the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So that's a wrap. For Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. With that, we sign off from MetLife Stadium.